I'm Fraser Cain, the publisher of Universe Today. What's the best way to explore the solar system? Should we send humans or robots? Robots are durable and replaceable, while humans are creative and flexible. Space advocates line up on both sides of this discussion, and the debate can get heated. Really heated. Don't be fooled. This whole conversation is a red herring. We shouldn't have to choose between human space exploration and robotic science, and it's absolutely ridiculous that the funding for it comes into a single agency. The future of humanity will depend on us learning to live in space, to get off this planet and spread to the rest of the solar system. The longer we remain trapped on this planet, the greater risk we face from a global catastrophe, whether it's from an asteroid strike or a global plague. We as a species are keeping all our eggs in one basket. I don't need to tell you how important science is. Our modern marvels are a direct result of the scientific method. The fact that you can even see this video should be all you need to know about the importance of science. And we have no idea what we're going to find out there in space when we go exploring. Were it up to me, I'd separate space exploration into two agencies with completely different agendas and budgets. On the science side, we need a fleet of robotic spacecraft and satellites continuously launching into space. We'd settle on a rugged, multi-purpose vehicle which carries a variety of payloads and scientific instruments. The Curiosity rover was an amazing success, and NASA should just keep building more rovers exactly like it. Give it cameras, grinders, and scoops, but then keep the instruments open to the scientific community. Every 2 years, another identical rover will blast off to the red planet, hurling a fresh set of instruments to a new location. Let's send a rover and an orbiter every 2 years to Mars and similar probes to other worlds. Only the scientific instruments would need change. In a few years, there would be versions of the exact same spacecraft orbiting planets, asteroids, and moons. Over time, our observation of the solar system would extend outward like a nervous system, gathering scientific knowledge at a terrific rate. For human space exploration, we need to learn to live in space in increasingly complex ways. Low Earth orbit, lunar orbit, on the lunar surface, on Mars, on asteroids, at Saturn, at the Lagrange points, etc. Remember the Gemini program back in the 1960s? Each mission was an incremental step, more complicated than the previous one. On one mission, the goal was just to learn if humans could survive in space for 14 days. In another mission, the goal was to learn how to dock two spacecraft together. This gave NASA the knowledge they needed to attempt an ambitious human landing on the moon. Instead of flying in low Earth orbit for decades, our human space program could continuously advance our knowledge of what it takes to survive and eventually thrive in space. If NASA investigates the technologies that the private sector considers too risky to invest in, it will help jumpstart space exploration. In this modern era of budget cuts, it breaks my heart that people are forced to choose between space science and human exploration. It shouldn't be this way. They have almost nothing in common. Let's do science because science is important. And let's put humans in space because humanity is important. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel over here. And maybe you've still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one. Or that one. And if you don't see the question you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.